certainly we thank God tonight for this ingathering of His people on this special occasion tonight, marking the 5th anniversary of this melodious group of singers, Sister Sally and the wonderful singers. I was not sure that I was going to make it because my wife's mother is being released from the hospital today, and we had to make arrangements for her to get home, and then my wife had to be there with her. But in the midst of it all, God is still good. If you were to really go back in your mind and really think, when I say think, become a critical thinker in terms of what God has already done, you'll come to the conclusion that He is better than good. God has done marvelous things for each and every one of us that's sitting here on today.
Amen.
Just tap your neighbor on the shoulder and look them square in the face, eyeball to eyeball, eyelid to eyelid. Say, neighbor, you're in the right place at the right time to receive just what you need from the Lord. Now, if you believe it, clap your hands. Clap them like you're sanctified. Clap them like you're filled with the Holy Ghost. Clap them like you're glad that you're in the land of the living, in the house of God. Hallelujah. When I think of the number 5 numerically in the Bible, it means grace and favor.
Thank you.
If I were to try and blend it from playing the Hammond B3 organ, it would be putting it into 2 different chords to bring together a crescendo. So when you consider what grace is unmerited favor being extended toward an undeserved people. The primary root of the word grace is denoted in the Greek as charis. It means that it's an act that demonstrates God's loving kindheartedness being extended toward an undeserved people. So don't take God's grace for granted. So when you enter into the 5th year or the 5th season of your life, there's an abundance of grace that flows. So from a crescendo standpoint, when you think the song has ended, it just carries on. So sometimes when you think that grace is over, in that 5th season of your life, it just continues on. And that's why you're here today. Not of any goodness of your own, but by the grace of God, we're here. The word of God in Psalms 100 admonishes us. It says, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, every soul standing for the hearing of the word of God. Every soul standing. Now I'm going to do you like I would do folks in my church. Y'all have to be quiet.
All right.
Because you're in the presence of the Lord.
Yes.
Let everything that hath breath praise ye the Lord. Psalms 100 says, make a joyful noise with the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before His presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, He is God. It is He that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are the sheep of His pasture. Enter into His gate with thanksgiving. Into His courts with what? Praise. Be thankful unto Him, and bless His name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and His truth endure to all generations. Grab your neighbor by the hand if you don't mind. Hold the hand firmly as a point of contact. Father, we thank You for this glorious occasion. A time, God, where we are able to come before Your presence to praise You, to magnify You, and to honor You as the God of our salvation. We realize, God, that if it had not been for You on our side, we would ask the question, where would we be? But because of your grace and your mercy, we have congregated ourselves together in the house of worship one more time to give you praise, to give you reverence, to give you honor, to say much of lies, to pay homage to you for all the things you have done for us. Because, God, if it would have been left up to the hand of the enemy, we would have been consumed. We would have been overcome. We would have been afflicted in many different ways. But, God, because of your grace and your mercy, we are standing. In the midst of all that we have been through, we are still standing. We acknowledge your presence here today. We don't want to ask you for anything. We just want to say thank you for being better to us than we've been to ourselves. Thank you for bringing us through the floods, through the storms, and through the rains. You have just been a mighty good God to us one and all. Thank you for healing our bodies, regulating our minds, food on the table, clothes on our back. Thank you, God. Roof over our heads. Thank you for being a God of abundance and grace, our provider, our way maker. We thank you tonight. So, God, as we enter into your presence tonight, God, we ask one thing of you, that you be glorified in everything that's done here in your presence. This we do ask in Jesus' name, and the saints of God shout it, hallelujah. Come on and shout hallelujah. Clap your hands like you lost your mind and say, God, I've got to thank you. As you take your seats, and as the praise and worship team comes to lead us into praise and to worship. Now again, if I was in my church, I would tell you there's no need to work the praise and the worship team to death. It ought to be easy for them to lead us into praise and worship because we have a relationship with God. So if you just meditate on his goodness and all the things he's done for you, it won't take us long to be ushered into his presence. Amen? Amen. You're in the hands now of the praise and worship team.
Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. Somebody. Praise the Lord. Somebody. Isn't God good? Do you love him today? If you love him, put your hands together as fast as you can and just tell him, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to you, God. I just want you guys to just think about every word that we sing in the songs that we may be doing during praise and worship. All right? I want you guys to just think about, apply those words to your life. Okay? Apply it to your situation, your present time, to your journey. I want you guys to don't focus on us. Okay? Because I love God so much, I love to see my God glorified. I love God so much, I love to just proclaim his name to the nations. I love God so much that I am so grateful for what God has done to me. And Bishop said something when he said, talked about grace. How many of y'all thank God for that grace? Let me tell y'all something. I might be a little transparent right here now. Catch this.
Yes, yes.
Through my lifetime, God, I have not always been a good guy. Mama and Daddy brought me up in a sanctified home, and I love God for the parents that he gave me. But it's been many times that I strayed away, and I consciously knew what I was doing when I did. But one thing I always remember and I thank God for it is Jesus. Yeah. Because when Jesus died on that cross, that grace was extended to me and I realized that. And that made me love him even more. And because I love him even more, that made me want to try harder to stay on the right path. Because I love God just that much. You see what I'm saying? So that's why when I come to church, it ain't hard for me to worship and praise God. You know why? Because I do this in my car. I do this when I get up in the morning. So when I get here, it's not hard for me to do. So y'all come on and just be with us. What can you do?
I just want to praise you.
Put your hands together.
Oh,
those hands and give God some praise in this building. Come on, don't pity that Jesus. Give the Lord a thunderous praise because he deserves it. Hallelujah! 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 He's worthy to be praised. One last time, let's give God a hand praise. Come on, love him. Put some praise on it. He deserves it. We would like to welcome everybody here on this program, on this evening. We are planning to have fun with Jesus on tonight. It's not just you were invited, but you was appointed by God to be here. And we are expecting a healing, a deliverance service to take place in this house. So if you're looking to be healed tonight, if you're looking to be delivered tonight, I just want to let you know before you leave this place, there is a miracle is going to take place in your life. Amen. And we just want to have fun with Jesus. In Jesus' name. Okay, at this time, I would like for everybody to stand on your feet. And we are going to welcome the honorarians on tonight. Let's receive at this time AVOG and IVOP. Come on, give God some praise for them. Come on, let's receive them. Hallelujah. Come on, you can do better than that. Give them some praise. Hallelujah. Let's receive them once again.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Amen. They're going to do an A selection, and then they're going to come back, because we have some great talent here on tonight. Amen. I feel so blessed and honored not just to have my group here, but my choir that I directed for over 19 years. Amen. I thank God for those that are here. All of them are not here, but I thank the Lord for those that I made. And this is our reunion. Amen. And I bless you all. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you.
1-2. There it is. Now give God the hand praise. Hallelujah. Holy Ghost, fall down on me. Hallelujah. If God is good, isn't he? When the choir was singing about the Holy Ghost, it reminds me when I first got saved, man. The Holy Ghost came down. It took me back to the day of Pentecost when a mighty rushing wind just came through the place. And it saturated among the apostles. People was filled. Ooh, my God. I remember that time when I was lost, but now I'm found. I am a child of God. He just rained on my life. Hallelujah. Okay, at this time, moving on, we're going to ask the musicians if you all can give us a musical selection. I know it was spontaneous, but if you all can give us a quick musical selection. Come on, come on, musicians. Praise him with a high sound, his cymbals. Praise him with the instrument and dance. That's what the scripture says. Psalms 150. Come on, musicians. Come on, let's receive the musicians in Jesus' name.
Thank you.
give God some praise. Thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, God, hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, God, we honor you. We bless your holy name, God, hallelujah. You're worthy to be praised, God, hallelujah, Jesus. Oh, God, we just thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What is the highest praise? What is the highest praise? Just the highest praise. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. He glorified your name. Took us back in the 90s, but today is still in our soul. And it reminds me of the old school when they said, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, hallelujah. Just think about the goodness of Jesus. You just want to give him some praise. Woo, hallelujah. Woo. My God, my God. Thank you, Lord. Yes, 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 yes. All that you do. Can we just get a 30-second praise? Come on, here we go. 1, 2, 3. Jesus' name, come on. All right, come on, show them some love. Come on, show them some love.
Amen. Oh,
your purpose, for his purpose. Come on, let's give it to him. Hallelujah. Turn to your neighbor and say, neighbor, I am blessed right now. There's favor on my life. I am blessed right now. That's why I'm standing here. I am blessed right now. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a hand praise once again. He's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. At this time, let's receive the honoraries on tonight. AVOG, come on. Let's receive them with some love. Come on. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
the Lord. Hallelujah. Can't do nothing without His grace or His mercy. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Oh,
Amen. I still got my reunion choir behind me. Amen. Amen. God bless you.
You're my hero.
There's none like you.
There's none like you.
tonight. It's not no mistake that you're here on tonight. So just give him praise. I know you've been hurting. I know you've been crying. I know you don't know what the money is coming from to pay those bills. But God is your provider. He's your way maker. If you're sick in your body on tonight, he's your healer. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Come on, let's just keep it there with uplifted hands. Come on, let's take out the time and begin to worship him. Come on, with uplifted hands. Come on. The Bible says God is the spirit. They that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. Come on, everybody all over this house. Begin to lift up those holy hands and worship him. Hallelujah, Jesus. Oh God, hallelujah. You're my hero. Come on, hallelujah. Then lifting up those hands means it's a sign of release. Surrendering unto God. Hallelujah. Come on, hallelujah, hallelujah, Jesus. Come on and worship him. Come on, saints. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. Charge the atmosphere of worship. Jesus, hallelujah, Jesus. Oh God, we honor you, Jesus. Oh God, we honor you, just bless your holy name. Come on, hallelujah. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and enter into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his holy name. Come on and bless him. Hallelujah, hallelujah. God is doing something right now. Hallelujah, we want to stay in that atmosphere of worship. From your worship, hallelujah, there's healing taking place through your worship. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Somebody's been set free right now through your worship. Hallelujah. God is enlarging your territory through your worship. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh God, hallelujah, Jesus. Oh God, hallelujah. Your worship. Your worship will eventually enlarge your territory. When we try to get somewhere, when we try to get out of our situation, God just wants us to stand just at the cross where he died for our sins that we may live today and begin to reverence him and honor him. Hallelujah. Because he is our hero. Now give the Lord a hand praise. Hallelujah. We honor you, Jesus. Come on, you can do better than give God some praise.